of the glory, worthy of the honor. Hallelujah. We can do better than that tonight. We can do better than that tonight. He is worthy. He is worthy. We were praying, and I was just thinking about something. Yasmin came back, and she said, "Oh, you're in a good mood today." She said, "School out, eh?" I said, "Yeah, man. No children. I didn't have to teach any children today." And I just stood, and I thought, wow, how my circumstances, they change. They switch. They good days, bad days. And people can tell by my face how my day is. And I thought about God. He doesn't change. The same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He isn't affected by my mood. He's not affected by my good day. And I thought, wow, what a privilege to come into his presence and just be in a good mood because he's God. Just be happy because he is God. He is a God that doesn't change. His love is from everlasting to everlasting. His mercies are new every day. He's the Alpha and the Omega, the Ancient of Days, who was, is, and is to come. That's the God that we serve. So I dare you tonight just to put a smile on your face and think about your God. Forget about your day. Forget how it went, how good or how bad it was. But just think about Jesus' goodness, his faithfulness. That just doesn't change. And bless him. And bless him. We bless you, God. We bless you because you're worthy. Hallelujah. Let's sing that one more time. Blessing and glory,
wisdom and power.
But you're my rock. In you will I trust because you never change. My strong tower. Yes, and my refuge. Savior, deliverer. One more time. We give him blessing and glory.
Blessing and glory.
Among this people in this gathering, and he will have his perfect way. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You don't have to wait for a song to get his glory to rise on your voice and on your praise. You don't have to wait for a song to let him know that you are here for him and you're waiting on his presence to move in this place. Amen, amen, hallelujah. 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 Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the song of our King rise. That has to rise from your mouth. No one else can do the job for you. Hallelujah. Let's put those hands together. Yeah, yeah.
Let them rise.
your spirit move as we shout our praise from our hearts to your ear. All the glory is yours now forevermore. Hear our worship, all we can give is for you. We're here for you, oh God, for you. We're here for you. Let me hear you say, oh, 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 oh. Church tonight. Oh, we're desperate, Lord, for a touch from you. You don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from you. You don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from sing. If you don't come, we won't move.
This has to be more than just words we say. We have to mean that. And if we do, I promise you, he will come in power. I promise you, his presence will fill this house. But we have to mean it when we say it. Lord, we're desperate, we're desperate, we're desperate. Oh God, if you don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch. If you don't come, if you don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from you. If you don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch. If you don't come, God, yeah.
We won't move. We're desperate, Lord.
Oh, sing it loud like you want him in this place.
We won't move.
We're desperate, Lord, for a touch. If you don't come, if you don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from. We need you, God, in this place to fill every heart. If you don't come, God. If you don't come, God,
we won't move.
Our hearts are open. If you don't come, God, yes.
We won't move. Desperate, Lord, for a touch from you.
If you don't come, we won't move. Desperate, one more time, sing. If you don't come, if you don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from you. If you don't come, God,
we won't move. Lord, for a touch.
If
from
you don't
you.
Come,
if you don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from
if
you.
If
you don't come,
we won't
move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch
if
from you.
If you don't come, God,
if
your presence
move,
doesn't go before,
we're desperate, Lord, for a touch.
How will
you.
They know we are any
you
different?
Don't come,
so
we
need your presence.
Move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from you.
If you don't come.
We won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from you.
If you don't
come, we won't move. We're desperate.
Come on, one more time. If you don't come, if you don't come, God.
If you don't come, we won't move. We're desperate, Lord, for a touch from you.
If you don't come, God.
We won't move. Desperate, Lord, for a touch from you.
If you don't come, God. If you don't come, God,
we won't move. Desperate, Lord, for a touch from you.
You see, we're singing this song, it's almost as if it's about this moment, in this place, in this meeting, that if he doesn't come, we won't move. But there's something special about this house that means he always comes. We take it for granted, but he always comes. And so we don't really have to sing the song because he's going to come anyway. But as I'm singing this, I'm thinking about that circumstance in my life where I know I started on my way without him. But I've decided now that actually I'm going to stop here. I can't go any further, because if you don't come and tell me where to go, if it's back, I have to go, I'll go back. If it's right, if it's left, I'll do that. But I need you to step in, God, and be God, or I won't move. And suddenly that song awakens me and it means something different to me. That Father God, if you don't come, I will not move. I need a move. I need a touch. I need a word. I need a direction. And I understand that it doesn't have to come from a man of God. I know because your presence is in the place, is in the room, that word can come right now in this minute. So if you don't come, God, if you don't come, I won't move. I'm desperate, Lord, for a touch from you. If you don't come, I won't move. I'm desperate. For a touch, sing it for yourself. If you don't come, I won't move. I'm desperate, Lord, for a touch from you. If you don't come, I won't move. I'm desperate, Lord, for a touch from you. One more time.
If you don't come, I won't move. I'm desperate, Lord, for a touch from you.
I need
you,
God.
If you don't come, I won't move. I'm desperate, Lord, for a touch.
Let your heart
you.
Cry out to him. Let it connect with your Father who hears your cry sometimes even before you open your mouth. We need you, God. We need you. We need you. Like the air we breathe, we need you. Mm-hmm. In you we live. In you we move. In you we have our very being. So we need more of you. We'll never be satisfied, Father, because we know there's more to have of your presence, more to have of your spirit. So push, 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 because there's more. His presence is sweet always, but there's more, there's more, there's more, there's more. There's more, there's more. So we say, fill us up, God. We pray, fill us up, God. Fill us up, God. Fill us up, God, yeah. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory. Come, release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. Release, release the of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Shekinah glory come. Release the fullness of your spirit. Come on, sing. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory come. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Shekinah glory come. Release the fullness. Shekinah glory come, cause Lord you move,
we want more,
you speak, yeah,
we want more,
Lord you move,
we want more, we want the fullness,
oh Lord. If you want more, Lord, you move. Lord, you speak, yes. Oh, you move, yes. We want the fullness. Lord, you move, yes. We say speak, but we'll still want more. Sing, release the fullness, release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory, Shekinah glory come, Shekinah glory come. release the fullness of your spirit, God. Shekinah glory, come. Come on, open your mouth. Shekinah glory, come. As if you want him to fill it, sing, release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory, Shekinah glory, come. Shekinah glory, come. So we wait for you. We wait for you. We wait for you. To walk in the room. We wait for you. No one else will do, God. We wait for you. We wait for you. To walk in the room. Here we are. Here we are. Standing in your presence.
Here we are. Standing in your presence.
Kind of glory. Shekinah glory,
Shekinah glory,
here we are,
standing in your presence,
here we are,
here we are, standing in your presence, Shekinah glory, come down.
Without the music, sing, here we are, here we are,
standing in your presence, here we are. Standing in your presence, Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory,
here we are, here we are.
Standing in your presence,
here we are, God.
Here we are, standing in your presence, Shekinah glory, come down.
Just in your own words, cry out for him to fill, to move. Let him know that you're here for him, to hear from him, to be touched by him, to be filled by him again, because he's faithful just like that. He'll come again and he'll speak again and he'll move again because he loves you and he loves the presence. He loves being in your presence. As much as we love his, he loves ours. So here we are again, God. Here we are again, God. Here we are again. Here we are again. Hallelujah.
Through another day.
sing that one more time from the depth of your heart. I need
more, Jesus, more of you. I need
so much more, so much more. When I'm going out and when I'm coming in, on my job, everywhere I go, Lord, I need, oh God,
and sing, I need more, more, Jesus, more of you.
I need
so much more, Jesus, more. Yes, sir. The last time, come on, say it. I need
more,
Jesus,
more of you.
Sing, I need so much more, Jesus.
Woo!
Hallelujah. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, sing,
I need
more, Jesus, more of you, of you.
I need so much
more,
Jesus, more.
Hallelujah. So Father, now fill this place with more of you. We ask for more of you, more of you, more of you, more of you. We need more money. We need more doors open. We need more vehicles. But Father, ultimately, aside from all of that, God, we need more of you. We can't get the stuff. God, give us you, Father. God, you are the source of our strength, the strength of our life. In you, we live, move, and have our being. And so, God, we cry out for more. Our existence is in you. And so we need, God, more of you. So God, fill us now. Fill this place with your presence. Send that anointing that makes preaching and teaching easy. Send that anointing, God, that allows us to hear what your Spirit is saying. Send refreshing. Yes, I will. Thank you, Father. Send that refreshing now that only you can send. Glory, 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 glory. Kubrondo sheta bahande kide bahaso. Wow, he just walked in. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Just felt him walk into the room. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Oh yeah, it's appropriate now. Here we are, standing in your presence. Yeah, it's here now. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah. He's here. Shekinah glory. Here we are. Here we are. Standing in your presence. Ooh. Standing in your presence. Shekinah glory. Yeah. One more time. Here we are. Standing in your presence. Lord. Here we are. Standing in your presence.
Shekinah glory come down.
Shekinah glory
come down.
Here we are, standing in your presence.
Here we are,
woo!
Standing in your presence.
Shekinah glory.
Shekinah glory come down.
We're going to sing this line one time, then we're going to shout. Release the fullness. We release the
fullness.
Come on. Of your
spirit,
Shekinah glory come.
Shekinah glory come.
Release the fullness
of your spirit,
Shekinah glory.
Shekinah glory come.
Shekinah glory come.
Lord,
all right, now come on, open your mouth and cry out unto God. Come on, let's shout to God with the voice of triumph. That's what I'm hearing. Open your mouth, open your mouth, open. Just hold it for me. Come on, open your mouth. Just hold on to one now. Come on, open your mouth, open your mouth, open your mouth, open your mouth, open. Hallelujah. Praise Him, did an awesome job. You did a mighty job. Now come on, you usher yourself in. Come on, open up your mouth and just honor Him. I'm telling you, He's coming. He's here. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Keep it up, keep it up, keep it up a little while longer. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We sang it, but we mean it. If you don't come, we ain't gonna move. Come on. Hallelujah. I pray for healing of that pain. Right shoulder blade, glory to God. Right shoulder blade. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Good, clap your hands everybody. Come on, let's get going. Yeah. Hallelujah. This is what I felt led of God to do for about 5 minutes, to allow you to come and listen to me clearly. I don't want you to feel compelled to come. I grew up in a church environment when testimony service, if nobody came, they say, man go. No, I ain't want that one. I want somebody to come to share what God would have manifested, what God would have done in your life over the last 7 days. The Bible says we overcome by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of our testimony. We haven't done this in this building yet to allow some testimonies to come in. Now, people usually call me with their testimonies, but I want to give you an opportunity now to come and just to share, and we're going to celebrate with you. We're going to celebrate with you what God has done. Let's say, let's get 3 hot ones. We will. I will get some testimonies. I know you're grateful that God saved you when he saved you from a miserable life of sin. Hallelujah. And now you want those that know the virtues of prayer to pray your strength in the Lord, that when he should come or call, he would find you nothing less than a child of God. Amen. I just said it for all of us, all right? That's all of us. Now, I want to give room now that God has done something for you. You want to share to encourage us. God has manifested something in your life, and you want to share that with the wider congregation. I ain't going to stall you all day, but if there's someone that wants to come and share to strengthen all of us, all right, you don't have a long time. You can't come here to preach. Don't call a text. You just want to come to share a testimony. Come quickly. Come on, come on. Anybody wants to come? You're scared now. Come, come. Don't be scared. Come on, come on. Anybody wants to come? and share what God would have meant. Judy, I know Judy's coming. Judy, sit down. Judy said, I ain't coming. Judy said, no, he ain't seeing me. Judy, you ain't coming? No, you ain't coming? You want Peggy to come for you? Peggy can't come for you. Come, Sister Helen. Glory to God. Oh, we have two Helen. Sorry, not that Helen. Listen, not Helen. Yeah, this Helen. Only because your boy just gone. This Helen Senior.
Watch it. Okay, and because he said that, he kind of gave it away. But last week, Thursday, was my birthday. I hit a milestone. I turned 60. And that is a big deal to me because my sister, my oldest sister, she died in 73. She was just short of her birthday to make her 20. And I was convinced that I was going to be next. And every year, when it's my birthday, I would celebrate because it was like a big blessing. And I hit 40, I hit 50, and then it was like, I keep telling people I'm leaning on the door. I'm leaning on 60 real hard. Right. But when I hit it, I hit it. And I so thank God for that. Women have a problem telling their age. I don't. I would shout it from the rooftop because every birthday for me is a blessing. She died 31st of March, 1973. She got buried on the 8th of April. I got saved on the 15th. Got filled with the Holy Ghost in 1975 in the General Assembly in the Grove. And God has been so good to me. He has been awesome. And I so thank God for that. So it doesn't matter. I can turn 70. Don't make no difference to me. I tell everybody because that's a blessing to me. So I just thank God for that.
Big right there. Come on, let's thank God for Helen. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Amen. Anybody else? Anybody? That's Helen Hall, and that's Helen Bridgie. Amen. Helen Bridgewater. Yeah. Anybody else? Anybody else want to share a testimony? Just to encourage us. Again, the scripture, Revelation 12, 11 thereabouts says, I think 10 says something like this, for the accuser of the brethren has been cast down, who accused them day and night before our God. And then he says, and they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, and by the word of our testimony. All right. Somebody gonna try to call me testimony and tell you I hang up the phone on you. If you call me your testimony, I hang up the phone on you. I'm gonna be very rude. I'm gonna insult you, I'm gonna hang up the phone. Come now. This is your time now to share your testimony. In these last, Helen was good. Helen took a minute and 45 seconds. That means we get 3 minutes, 15 seconds left. Come on. Come Rose. Rose, you coming with your book?
Hello, everyone. No, I always have something to say, but I'm going to be brief. I just want to say, since I started coming to this church in January, I have gotten two raises. Two. Yes, two raises. Hallelujah. That's all I got to say. Hallelujah.
That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. From January to now, two raises. Hallelujah. Someone shout, I love my church. And I love my God more. I know that's right. Hallelujah. Anybody else? That's you, Yasmin? Or you just talking for them? Amen. Hallelujah. Anybody else? That's going to come. Christelle in here. She called me. I can let her wait to do her own. Because she got something major too. So I ain't going to share it for her. She texted her to me this week. She said, actually, she texted to my old phone, so I didn't see it because she wanted to get a testimony in May. Because May was out. We're talking about increase. And hers came in May. And hers came heavy in May. So that's a May testimony, but I can wait till she had to share that one. That's big. Big things are going. Yeah, glory to God. We thank God for it. Nobody else. Okay. Yes, Susie. Come. Come, clap for Susie. Y'all in the church. You will clap. People come in. Encourage them.
Good night. Since I came to Nassau, it was hard for me to find a job. And I joined a program with the Ministry of Youth, Sport, and Culture, which teaches you a skill. And when you learn a skill, then you get certified or you get a certificate, and then they place you on internship. And I didn't get back to you. It was hectic. Honestly, the studying was hectic. We had to learn like three different topics in one and a half month. And we had seven tests, inclusive of Bahama Host. And so I passed all seven tests, and I was just waiting on my grades. To tell you, Bishop, I was waiting on my grades. But I passed all seven tests. Now I'm on internship. Now hopefully I'll be able to get the job.
We cast down that hopefully and declare when she finishes internship, even before she finishes internship, she gonna be. Can we say amen to that? Can we agree to that? That before internship over, she gonna be confirmed. Yeah, she gonna be confirmed. Glory to God, proud of you, man. I so love Susie's spirit, you know, that there's so many people saying, I ain't got no job. She had no job, so she go outside and learn something. It makes sense. Because a lot of folks staying home complaining, I ain't got no job. She heard about that program, and she enrolled in the program. That meant, when I heard her say that, I was so encouraged by that, you know, because there's so many people who, last year to this year, their excuse is, I ain't got no job. They ain't no smarter. They ain't no more prepared. They ain't no more qualified, but a year's gone by, and the story is still the same story. I ain't got no job. So 3 months later, this girl done learned things. She done passed Bahama Host now, and now she can do all kind of things. Now she qualified, and she about to find work, because she applying kingdom principles. So she going to find some work. Someone said, got to work. No, I mean that. She's applying kingdom principles. We can't. And we got to change our language, and hopefully she can get a job. We're teaching about the promises being fulfilled. She's applying herself. She didn't go in there and prepare herself. She's going to get that job quick, fast, and in a hurry. It's going to happen, and God going to be glorified. Hallelujah. And she can carry her pastor for lunch. Yes, she will. She's going to bless her pastor. Amen. They're going to be done. Rosie ain't called me yet, but the call coming. Glory to God. You know, we're going to eat good, me and Rose together. Robin. Mm-hmm. Let's go to the word of God. We're going to have, I feel led of God to have, to begin regular nights of impartation where we would just have time for laying hands and praying for persons. We're going to begin that real soon. We're going to do it at least once per month. And somebody said, well, we pray for people all the time, but no, we want to set aside a night just for that, with that purpose, where we will just be praying for persons, and you could bring your sick loved ones and all. I don't know if I want to call it a healing service or whatever the case is. I don't want to put it in no box. You know, it's just going to be a time of impartation. However the Lord moves, however it happens, however he manifests, healing, casting out the devils, however that works. I'm here smiling internally, because usually when people talk about this kind of service, there's top of the hype. You know? Bless God, glory to God. The Spirit of God said to me, now we got to begin these services. It's going to be a mighty, mighty move of God. Bring the sick, bring the lame, bring those that are dead. Bring them. Bring them in casket. Bring them however you want. Bring them. And God is about. No, I get that. No. Bring them. They got demon, bring them. They blind, bring them. They lame, bring them. And we believe it's going to be a mighty move of God. We don't say it as though we're surprised. We say it as though that's what's supposed to happen. Say amen to that. All right. So that's going to happen. And I'm quite confident the first service of that nature is going to be next week, Tuesday night. That's the way I feel led now. I was going to say, tell Delton, you know, print flyers and that kind of stuff like that. It's a spirit move. So I can, you know, I move and God's a move, you know. So if we get clarity on it between now and Sunday, we'll have something out to spread the word about next week, Tuesday night. Now we're going to just believe God and lay hands and let the Lord have his way. Glory to God. Amen. In addition to that, on this coming Sunday is our baptism. Baptism is this coming Sunday. I think we have, last count was about 11 people. Give God glory for that. Amen. Y'all clapping really, really, y'all hearty. Yeah, it is kind of warm. Boy, summer coming, boy. Some are coming fast. You know. It here. Lord God is here. So we're looking now. Look, we gotta do some more air. We gotta bring some more air. And I know some of you all deep say, Pastor, just stop making it comfortable. They need to be hot. Okay. The Lord bless you. So we need to get some more air. We need to get some more air. We're working on that. So we get the target was for two more units. We got one. We'll get the next one, and then see how that goes from there. But we need to move in that regard, and move with haste. Y'all have no problem just moving with haste with that, right? Doing that fast. Good. Get your Bibles now. I think that's the last announcement. The baptism on Sunday, right after service. Right after our service, we're gonna go to the beach for that baptism service. And so let's govern ourselves accordingly. Also on next week Sunday, as those persons will be baptized, we will also have a communion service that Sunday morning. So we'll be doing communion next week Sunday, preparation for baptism on next week. All right, let's go to the Word of God. Get your Bibles, Galatians chapter number 1. Once you have it, rest on your feet to honor the Word of God. Galatians chapter 1. Hallelujah. Galatians 1. Marsha, stop playing fast. That's all right, Marsha. You understand. Galatians 1 from verse 15 down to verse 2. I said, that was all right. You wanted to move? Back. Go ahead. Glad to have Jody back. Went home, Jamaican, came back to us. I was scared she was going to come back. But thank God she came back. Welcome back, Jody. Welcome back. And she came back bearing gifts for her good pastor. So love her. So love her. I like when my members go to Jamaica. They always bring back things. Yeah, Marsha just came and she brought back things now. Jody going, anybody else going to Jamaica? Bring back more things, man. Love it. Love it. Delicious. Hold on. Bring my things, you know, legal things, you know. Things that you can declare. Things that are declarable. Galatians 1 from verse 15. Through to verse 24. Amen. Ready? Our word declaration. We believe that the Lord Jesus Christ is the only begotten Son of God. He gave his life as a ransom on the cross of Calvary, making eternal and abundant life available to all that would believe in his triumph over Satan for the redemption of mankind. We believe. Of the blood of Jesus Christ and faithful application of this word causes us to continually triumph over Satan and his demonic host. I now receive the word. Amen. Verse 15 says this, but when it pleased God, who separated me from my mother's womb and called me by his grace. You read 16. Neither went I up to Jerusalem to them which were apostles before me, but I went into Arabia and returned again unto Damascus. Amen. Who's that? The headache is shot. Who that is? And crown, eye and crown, a headache. I just felt the sharp pain. It came and went, and it came back again and went. And I know that's somebody. I know that's somebody watching online. Father, we command healing now in the name of Jesus. We curse that. Oh, there comes that anointing that goes with it. Thank you, Holy Spirit. There's that anointing. Glory to God. Glory to God. Whoever that is, put your hand on your head. Put your left hand on your head. Father, I command healing now in the name of Jesus the Christ. Be healed. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. Take your hand off of them. Take your hand off of them. It's a nerve condition. Something to do with your nerves. It's a long name too. The condition. R-E-C-T is in it, and then it's long from there. Something like that, some long nerve name. The condition that they said you have. Be healed now in the name of Jesus. Every knee got to bow to the sound of Jesus Christ, greatest name that exists. And so because it can be named, it has to bow. So we command healing to manifest. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. You spirit of infirmity, go back to the pits of hell from whence you came. Be healed, daughter, in Jesus' name. And it is so for the glory of God. Give God a good praise right there. Hallelujah. 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 God is starting to, let me just say for somebody, God is starting to manifest himself to me more and more by way of, the best way I can define this, by way of intercession. By way of intercession. Where I am starting to feel the conditions of persons more often. More often. More often. It's happened a whole lot. Man of God, I won't call his name because I don't think, what you think, I'm name dropping. But I was very surprised when he called me. He says, Bishop, I'm led to call you. I haven't told my church and other persons. It was a pretty major man of God here in the nation. He haven't told my church, but I'm going off to have a procedure done. And the Lord told me to call you to come into agreement. And so he called me. I said, no problem. I'm going to be standing with you. And amazingly enough, the next day, my right eye, it began to swell. Told Robin about it. Some of the office staff saw it, and they said, "If you go into the doctor," I said, "No, the Lord spoke to me." You go in the doctor? No, why? You gonna get a checkup? No. You gonna buy some drops? No. And I called the man of God. I said, "Listen, let me just ask you a question. Is your right eye inflamed right now?" He said, "Yes, sir. It's the right eye that the condition is in." I said, "Well, glory to God." And so whenever it bothered me, I prayed for him. Then I sent him a text. He said, "Thank you, I needed it just now." And that's what happened for that entire time. Then my eye went down like last weekend. I called him and said, "How you doing?" He says, "Down." I said, "Glory to God. It's supposed to be." Hallelujah. So I thank God for that, and I'm sharing that because it may be somebody else that God is beginning to deal with you in that area. And so as you, glory to God, I feel a mighty anointing. I feel like I'm teaching something. That if you feel these funny conditions in your body that don't really match nothing. Am I making sense to you? Like out of nowhere, these pains or aches, like Sunday when we called out, who's that? Basau, with the pain under her breast, under her what is left or right breast, whichever one the Lord said that day. That has been happening with more frequency, with a greater frequency now. And so I want those of you that you have those kind of things, don't be afraid. Don't even be afraid to ask. What you have no reputation to protect. You in the presence of somebody, and all of a sudden, when sharp pain comes to you, ask them. You have a pain in your head, or you have a pain in your back. What do you have to lose by asking them? They say, "No, I ain't got no pain." Well, glory to God. You still pray for whoever that person is. Am I helping anybody? Let me ask this: can any of you relate to this? Like you would have this, like all of a sudden, like this. Even watch this. Even some people, it's depression. Out of the clear blue, you have an awesome day, nothing going wrong, nothing bad happened, you ain't broke, you and your spouse ain't row, and just the spirit of heaviness come on you from nowhere. And what we do sometimes, we bind the devil, where it is actually you being called to intercession. And for many times, we can miss an assignment. I'm teaching better than y'all receiving this. God is not authorized to intervene on earth unless we ask him. Because he gave us dominion of the earth. He gave us charge. I'm in the word. He gave us control over this earth. In order for him to intervene, there must be a partnership with a human. There got to be human partnership. There got to be a prayer being prayed somewhere. Now watch this, watch this. Sometimes though, head is a context, God is cheap. You see, because you say you got the Holy Ghost. And you said, Lord, I yield my life to you. When you said, God, I yield my life to you, you give God permission to send you a download. Are you getting this? So almost like he kind of cheating you, because he cannot heal that person unless there is a prayer request made. Because we have dominion in the earth. So what he'll do, he'll send a hint. Because you prayed and said, Father, I'm yours, I'm your servant, use me however you see fit. He said, got one. And so by that prayer, he is authorized to send the Holy Spirit to give you one little indicator. And that indicator goes off. Now it's your job to now ask him to intervene. Am I making any sense here? So what am I saying? Don't take those moments lightly. We're trying to develop a spiritual people. And people are going to say, you're so heavenly minded. Tell them, yes, I am. Thank you for complimenting me. I am heavenly minded. I just got a pain in my back. Father, who is that back pain? I command healing over them right now in Jesus' name. Get like that. Get like that. Who knows whose miracle is waiting on you to give God permission? Whose healing is waiting on your prayer to be prayed? Do not, are y'all here? I need y'all to really hear what I'm saying. Do not take these moments lightly. Sinus go off for no reason. You ain't had no, nothing came to give you no allergy. You ain't eat nothing to set your allergies off. Ain't no dust around you, and your sinus just going off. Father, who is that? Who is that person? I command their sinuses now to be cleared up now in the name of Jesus. How many of y'all can commit to be more sensitive? Like, you know what, God, I want to be more sensitive. I want to be more sensitive. I ain't going to miss no more moments. Because I've been missing moments. And I asked a question, I didn't need to answer. Let me ask the question now. Based on that whole layer I just gave you, how many of you can say, you know what? That probably happened to me in the last 2 weeks and I missed it. Like, honestly. Father, I pray over everyone that raised their hand and those that didn't. God, that you would make us all more sensitive. Cause your spirit in us to be so alert that right away, as opposed to going into panic mode for ourselves, we would go into intercession mode. For whoever that person may be, give us that spiritual sensitivity, that alertness in the spirit, Father, to move quickly to assignment rather than to go into defense. Cause us to go quickly into offense. And that prayer is sealed now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Clap your hands if you received that just now. That's good teaching just now. Glory to God. Where were we in the scripture? Who was reading, me or y'all? Y'all? What's the last one y'all read? Abode with him 15 days. Okay, I on 19 then. But other of the apostles saw I none, save James the Lord's brother. 20. Afterwards I came into the region of Syria and Cilicia. But they had heard only that he which persecuted us in times past now preacheth the faith which once he destroyed. Together the last verse. And they glorified God in me. That's so big. They glorified God in me. They didn't glorify me, but they glorified the God in me. I want you to go to five people, tell them, welcome to the life experience. It's probably too hot. They would probably want you to hug them. Just shake their hand. And those of you on the outside, come to the inside. Let's fill these two middle sections, please. Those on the wings, please come to the middle. Let's get quickly into this word. Amen. Come on in the middle, please. Come in the middle. Come in the middle. Come on in the middle. Amen. Hi, beloved. How are you? No. Thank God for you. Spirit of obedience. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Awesome. Good. Someone look at the camera. Let me know how we're looking. Let me know if we need to change. Good. Who? Oh, Jessica, come in and sit up next to her now, eh? So that'll take care of that. Good. Thank you. You got to move over one. Move the stuff. Let's come over one.